Greetings and welcome to Chapter 7 of the AESDirect video webinar series. In this chapter, I'll cover the columns that will be displayed on your Shipment Manager screen, along with several filters that you can use to navigate through multiple shipments. So on our Shipment Manager screen, you'll notice that we have all shipments that have been filed in the last 3 months. And there are several columns that you can sort by. You'll notice the filer ID, the shipment reference number, and that's the number that you create for your own internal reference. You'll notice the status of your shipment, whether it's been accepted or rejected, the last action on your shipment, whether it's been canceled or added, the shipment's ITN number, the last update of the shipment, along with the time, the user who last updated the shipment. If you hold your mouse cursor over it, it provides you with the name, the date of export on your shipment, the U.S. principal party and interest, the U.S. principal party and interest's ID number, along with the ultimate consignee. And you'll also have your shipment actions column on the far right-hand side of the screen. And if it's not displayed there, you'll notice it on the far left-hand side, just under the green plus sign if you click it. And now if you want to sort through your shipments, say you have a wide variety that you need to navigate through, you can show the system's filters. And from here, you can filter by the USPPI name, the USPPI ID, the consignee name, the country of destination, the port of export, the carrier SCAC or IATA, the username, and then I'll also show you our date range feature where it says filings updated in. Now the system's default display will show the shipments for the last 3 months, but let's say you have a shipment that's a bit older than that. You can select the custom button and you can provide a custom date range. One note about this is the custom date range will only search 90 days at a time. So if you enter a date range that's greater than 90 days, the system will not find any results. So my date range will be January 1st of 2018. And you'll notice I have November 7th of 2018. And the system tells me that the dates must be within a 90-day period. So we will modify this to show March 1st of 2018. And that now pulls up all of the shipments from January 1st to March 1st that I filed. And you can notice that by your last updated column. You see a shipment from February 26th, a shipment from January 30th, and so forth. This concludes Chapter 7. Please advance to Chapter 8, where I'll cover the system's template manager and profile manager.